Well, how does one remove fluoride from drinking water? Well, there are two basic ways to do this. One is the use of reverse osmosis, and the other are countertop filters. So there are advantages and disadvantages of each, but the two main questions are effectiveness and cost. So for effectiveness, to be able to say they remove fluoride, they have to be at least 81% effective. Now, most are going to go for higher than that. For reverse osmosis, and both reverse osmosis and some countertops, they're typically going to be above 90%. So it's pretty good. The advantage of reverse osmosis is chances are you're going to get the most consistent removal of fluoride. For countertops, you have to be careful because some, especially the smaller ones, are not going to be able to remove fluoride. You have to check very carefully. Others will. So it comes down to checking, you know, basically just Googling, I would suggest, on different brands to find out which are most comfortable. I'd highly recommend that any brand you check has an independent test for showing how much of the fluoride that they do remove. And second are the costs. Generally, they're pretty close because you're gonna have to have separate filters for the countertops. Right around to start to install either system, you're gonna be running probably at least $300 to do this. It could go higher. For reverse osmosis, if you're a handy person and can install them yourself, then it'll be a lot cheaper. But if you have to hire a plumber, it's going to be significantly more. For the countertops, anybody can do it. It doesn't require any technical knowledge. So, but figure around $300 a piece to start, and it could be more. The cost for the filters will be a little more, I think, for the countertops and the reverse osmosis, but for reverse osmosis, you may have to be using a lot more water, say at least 2 gallons or 3 gallons of regular water to get 1 gallon of unfluoridated. So unfortunately, what this does, I mean, it's good for removing fluoride, but if you're a low income, and this is where the social justice of aspect of this enters in, if you're a low income family, you can't afford this, which I think is a major point we want to make, that this just isn't fair for low-income families, for anyone really, but especially them, because they're not going to be able to avoid the fluoride because they simply can't afford the filters or the other alternative is just to constantly buy unfluoridated bottled water.